pyrexide on compounds of boron. Compounds of boron. First one is B2O3. Boron trioxide. Boron trioxide. Write down, it is the anhydride of. There are other ways also, like we are doing only the important one. Write down next, boron trioxide B2O3. This is an anhydride of orthoboric acid. Orthoboric acid. Orthoboric acid is H3BO3. H3BO3, when you heat this, it converts B2O3 plus H2O. So since water molecule eliminates here, that's why this is the anhydride of this. Okay, water molecule.
So why do we call it orthoboric acid? Like, where does the ortho come from?
Ortho para se kuch iska ye nahi hai. It's just the name of this. Okay, iska, there's no answer for this. This is the name of this. We have the. What is your name?
So there's a lot of compounds which have ortho in their name. Is that just like that?
इसको boron क्यों बोलते हैं? Like what can you do the answer? What is the answer for this one?
So, but is
what,
it,
what if I name, your name is Ruchir? Yeah.
So, is it the same for all other compounds, like all non-organic compounds that have ortho and all of that in their name?
Ortho substituent product is defined in organic chemistry when the groups attached at ortho because of the position defined. Yeah. Here we don't have such things.
So but even in inorganic, you have some compounds that start with ortho or mega or something.
बहुत कुछ है ortho है pyro है pyro sulfuric acid है pyro phosphoric acid है.
So those are just names.
They are just names.
No reason.
No reason. Nothing. Okay. So we have many things to memorize here, right? ऐसे अगर करोगे नाम क्यों है तो बहुत मुश्किल है. Right. So try to keep it, you know, confined. बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है. नेम का कोई रीजन नहीं है. हाँ, इन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री देर आर पोजिशन डिफाइंड ऑर्थो पैरा एंड मेगा. सो वहाँ पे भी है. यू कैन ऑल्सो आंसर वो पोजिशन ऑर्थो क्यों है. सो कोई आंसर नहीं हो सकता. अंडरस्टूड दिस. सो बेंजीन इफ यू राइट ऑन दिस व्हाई दिस इज ऑर्थो. इसे क्या आंसर मैं करूँगा है भाई ऑर्थो मान केमिस्ट्री में यू कैन नॉट डू लाइक दिस. फिजिक्स अगर फिजिक्स लगाओगे देन इट इज प्रॉब्लम. Right. Try to understand that way. So, orthoboric acid, B2O3, first of all, it is an anhydride of orthoboric acid. This is important. They ask this, the anhydride of H3BO3 is what? That is B2O3. Okay? Important. Another method is what? Boron, when reacts with water, KO2, it forms B2O3. Preparation of this. This compound, we also call it as It is a white crystalline solid. Write down fast. Carbon भी करना है. It is a white crystalline solid. Not important. Hygroscopic image. What is hygroscopic image? It has affinity towards water. Yes, affinity towards water. Hygroscopic in nature. Write down the reaction B2O3 plus H2O. Hygroscopic in nature, B2O3 plus H2O forms HBO2, metaboric acid. Bull while meta.
So it doesn't form ortho.
No.
How do you form ortho?
Which one? Orthoboric. How will you do that? The preparation correct. It's just see, there is a reaction of decomposition at different temperature. So at different temperature, you'll get different compounds. So we'll see that. Okay, and that is important also. Temperature dependent reaction, that is.
This is at more temperature.
This is just boron we have, so around 600 Kelvin we are using.
And that one, sir?
It's a high temperature only, so that will be around 400 to 500, 450 only.
So this is
high temperature. Reaction of this one, no? B2O3 with water. B2O3 with H2O gives HBO2. HBO2, that is metabolic acid. HBO2, again oxide, B2O3 alkyl. Gives HBO2 first. This further reacts with water and forms H3O. So this is the reaction. The overall reaction is this. It depends upon what temperature, what amount of water you are taking.
So sesame oxide requires a higher temperature than orthoboric acid.
No, because whatever temperature we use here we have a lesser temperature. Otherwise, this will not form, but this was seen. If the temperature is more than this one over here, then this B2O3 will also.
So you said this one's 600 and that one's 400.
This is the temperature here, and here is lesser than this.
Okay.
Orthoboric acid, next right on. Next compound is borax. Borax is Na2B4O7 sodium tetraborate. Borax, Na2B4O7 sodium tetraborate. It can be obtained from boric acid. That is H3BO3. H3BO3 reacts with Na2CO3, and it forms Na2B4O7 plus H2O plus CO2.
So, but now this is boric acid.
This one. Huh? Orthoboric acid and boric acid both are same thing. H3BO3 is orthoboric acid or simply boric acid. B2O3 is boric oxide, boric anhydride, oxide, right? So this is right on. It is boric acid, or we also call it as orthoboric acid. Okay. So with Na2CO3 it forms Na2B4O7. It can also obtain from colemanite mineral. Also obtained from colemanite mineral. So this is Ca2B6O11. Formula is important for colemanite. Ca2B6O11 plus Na2CO3. It forms Na2B4O7 plus CaCO3 plus CaCO3 and sodium metaborate, NaBO2. It is colemanite mineral. Now you see, there is a compound called prismatic borax. Formula for this, they have asked this question, Na2B4O7, it is the hydrated form, decahydrated form, .NH2, is prismatic borax, .NH2. Octahedral form, prismatic, prismatic borax. Another one is octahedral form, octahedral borax is .5H2. It is .5H2. Octahedral borax is Na2B4O7.5H2. Borax glass is the anhydrous form, that is Na2B4O7. Borax glass is the anhydrous form, that is Na2B4O7. Okay, next write down.
So, heating.
Then .NH2, yeah. Octahedral is 5H2. next slide down, the action of heat, or we also call it as heating effect. Action of heat. This is very important for exam. Depending upon the temperature, the product will be different. Okay, action of heat. I'll write down the reaction. If you have any 2B4O7, .10H2O, and when you heat this, it converts into the anhydrous form, and the temperature around we are using
Na2B4O7.
And the temperature here we are using around 900 degrees Celsius. All this water molecule goes off and we get the anhydrous form. Okay, further if you heat this at 740 degrees Celsius, it converts into sodium metaborate, NaBO2, and B2O3, boric anhydride. Right on. Boric anhydride reacts with copper sulfate and forms blue color complex of copper metaborate. Okay. So color, this is a boric bead test, we call it the boric bead test, right? So copper gives you blue, iron gives you green color, that you write on. Fe gives you green color, nickel gives you brown.
So you make it react with FeSO4.
CuSO4 plus B2O3.
And in case of FeSO4.
Solution of iron. So iron gives you green, nickel gives you brown. Okay? Next, one more reaction we have of borax. I'll write down the whole reaction here. SO4 plus. With copper, it forms CuBO2 whole twice. NiBO2 whole twice. Okay, the reaction of borax you write down with HCl. It forms H3BO3. We have seen this reaction. We can use HCl or we can also use H2SO4 for this purpose. H3BO3. Further, you heat this with NaOH. It forms sodium metaborate, which is NaBO2.
So what is
borax?
Like
borax
glass or prism?
It is anhydrous simply. Na2B4O7.
Isn't that borax glass?
Same thing. Anhydrous form. S3BO3, if you heat at 100 degrees Celsius, this is also important. S3BO3, if you heat at 100 degrees Celsius, it forms HBO2. Metaborate. Further, if you heat this at 160 degrees Celsius, it forms H2B4O7. This is metaboric acid. And H2B4O7 is tetraboric acid. S3BO3, heated strongly, it converts into B2O3, boric anhydride, which on reduction, we have seen this in Na and potassium, it gives you boron. Right? Boron when heated with nitrogen gives you boron nitride. Okay? Boron nitride is also obtained with boron when it is heated with NH4Cl.
So what temperature is that?
Generally very high temperature we use, around 700 degrees Celsius. All these reactions are very important, temperature also. What is the structure of Na2B4O7? Huh? Na2B4O7 dot 10H2O. What is the structure? See. This molecule, this is the actual bonding of this This is the structure.
This is the NA is attacked in those bones.
It is attached. This again is a complex compound. The structure of this part is this. Right on next. Halides of boron. Halides. BX3. Halides of boron. Right on, boron forms halides of BX3 type. What is the hybridization of this BX3? SP2. This is SP2 trigonal planar. BX3 is SP2 hybridized trigonal plane. Write down, these halides are covalent in nature. And why it is covalent? Because of small size of boron. Small size of boron, Paydan stool, it has more
high polarized.
Yes, yes.
So you say it's a dipole
will be zero. Right? Next write down. Covalent in nature, because of small size, it has low boiling point. And the boiling point increases with the atomic number of halogen. It is an electron deficient molecule. Lewis acid in nature. Behaves as a Lewis acid. Okay, so tell me one thing. What is the order of Lewis acid behavior of this? BF3, BCl3. BBr3 and BI3. Order? What? BI3. What is Lewis acid? Tendency to accept lone pair of players. So which one has maximum tendency to accept? BF3. So order should be what?
BF3.
Should be with lone
pair. This is the order of Lewis acid. Okay. okay? But this is wrong. Yes. So मैंने बताया एसटी में यंग जी. Why the order is maximum for BI3? Why this is the other way around? The order is. What is the order for the base user? That is wrong.
It's wrong.
Why? But then F3 will take the thing and then you can accept an electron. So it should be right.
So this is wrong.
So BCL3 will be the most acidic, then BF3, then BBr2.
No, it's just the other.
What is the answer?
BCL3 is the highest.
Which means?
So because CL CL pulls electrons is strong.
Why not have them?
No, but CL is the most.
Yeah. It has the highest.
See, the reason for this is, मैंने बताया आपको ये आपने. Reason is P5 P5 backbone.
P5 backbone.
That is the problem. जो concept है that you won't understand. पूछोगे orthobody कैसे नाम क्यों? क्या होगा?
We said backbone.
हाँ. हाँ, I didn't say wrong. So, नाम की पीछे नहीं पढ़ना है, कॉन्सेप्ट समझने की कोशिश करना है. What whatever thing is there to memorize, वो तो ठीक है याद करना है. चाहते नहीं आप? What is this P5 by backbonding?
So basically when the we can.
How many types of backbonding are
there?
हाँ, any example of P5 D5?
BCL3. Yeah. BBr3.
No. D कहाँ है वो?
So you need to think
like the third one.
No, so we'll never come unless you can, unless
A
is coming next. So we only, so like in
Korean,
we
didn't
know
that.
In this molecule, we have P5, D5 by body. This donates its electron to the vacant d orbital of p5 d5 backbone. See, actually what happens in BF3, Lewis acid is tendency to accept electron pair, right? Accept electron pair. Now this boron has vacant p orbital. I have discussed this in periodic properties. Right. Yeah, I'm going to discuss it. Boron has three lone pair, right? Sorry, fluorine. And since boron has one vacant p orbital, so this fluorine has tendency to donate this lone pair into the p orbital of this boron. Right? This p orbital, this lone pair is present in p orbital of fluorine. And this is also p orbital of boron. The vacant p orbital is of boron. This. Okay? So this is what? Since it donates electrons, so it is back bonding, since the bond has been formed already, and then this electron pair it donates, right? So it is back bonding, and since p orbital is involved, so it is p and p. The bond has pi characteristics, so it is p pi, p pi, back bonding. Okay? Now this kind of back bonding decreases the electron deficiency of this boron. Because here 6 was, now it donated, now 8 was boron, right? So electron deficiency of rain. Now, this kind of back bonding is maximum in BF3. If you talk about Bi3, so Bi3 may will have like this. We have electron pair presence in p orbital. This is the p orbital, right? Or here we have p orbital. Right. That's why the overlap is not possible. Size is comparable, so overlap is possible there, right? So here we have the best overlap. Is this molecule is the least electron deficient? Least electron deficient means the tendency to accept electron is minimum, and here the order is reverse. This is the Lewis acid. It's very important, okay? Okay.